We're here with Trey McGee. McDonogh scored the game-winning goal in overtime. Talk about that thrill. Great game. Just took 13 seconds.
Yeah, well, we weren't running breaks real well in the throughout the game. And then when it came into overtime in the last 10 seconds of the game, we talked to our faceoff guy. He's like, that we had to tell him that we needed the breaks and we needed to run the break right this time. And then we came out, ran the break right, and I had a wide-open shot. So it was Hill and the faceoffs that really gave it to me.
What's that feel like, Trey, winning, scoring a game-winning goal, especially a game of this magnitude?
Oh, my gosh. We talked about it all week, how big this game was and how much we needed to come out and just play our best. And it was like, it's every MIA game means the same.
Out.
But,
anytime.
You know, when you come out and beat St. Paul's on your home field, it's just like unreal.
And now, talk about your defense today. I mean, St. Paul's has had a knack lately of scoring late in the second half, scoring in bunches, and you guys really shut them down.
Yeah. At halftime, we weren't really happy with the way the defense had been playing. However, they held them to like 4 goals, I think, in the first half. But holding St. Paul's to 10 goals is ridiculous. We were talking about before the game that they haven't been held under 8 goals all season. And now our defense came out and did what they needed to do.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Congratulations.
Thank
well
you,
done.
Kid.
Good stuff.
Thank you.